port through the mid-south here, and then I think on, and I know on up into the Midwest, Texas, Oklahoma, California, North Dakota, in these areas, we've had a meeting on the thing, and we've got pretty good support on it last week, where everybody seemed to agree that they wanted to do something, so we're trying to get something done now as far as making some changes. And I just wonder if the thing gets to growing and make some headway, if you'd be willing to leave the good people in Georgia. this time it's wide enough out and it's just so many brush fires. Just so many brush fires going everywhere that they can't put them all out, you see. And that's the reason why we need to get one going in Georgia. So they spread the personnel a little bit thinner and they can't get the people around to do the axe work, you see. And if you got enough people moving one time, they can't be everywhere at once, you know. Yeah, but he's on the other side of the fence.
Is that right?
Yeah, he's on the other side of the fence. Well, you expected that, didn't you?
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah. But he's still right in there punching. But I think we got enough support if we depend on Georgia there, and I think Tennessee here, I think we're gonna get enough support out of Tennessee and Kentucky and Illinois. It's just everywhere. People that you would be surprised are supporting the thing, you know.
Yeah.
Just a whole bunch of them are supporting it. And that's a little bit surprising to me. But I think we're going to be able to put her together this time. Okay, well, listen, I don't want to keep you going too long, but I'll talk to you later about it, okay?
What did you say your name was?
Bobby Flowers.
Bobby Flowers?
Yes, sir.
What about the Tennessee you live?
Paris, Tennessee.
Paris,
Tennessee.
Uh-huh. Wait, let me get your telephone number.
Okay.
That's FLOWERS.
Right. Right. Paris, Tennessee. And my phone is 901-642-2496. 642.
Your number, please.
642-2496. Don?
Yes.
How's it going?
All right, Bobby, how are you?
Oh, I don't know.
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing really, I guess. I just talked to Marin Green down in Georgia.
Uh-huh.
Do you know him?
Yeah, well, served on the board with him.
Well, I talked to him, and he's got sugar diabetes, and he don't know, you know, how much strength he can muster up himself. But he seemed fairly receptive, and I don't know, I think maybe you might call him in a day or two, or I'll call him back in a day or two and check his temperature. But he seemed, you know, fairly receptive, and so I guess he'll come along with us. He also mentioned a fellow by the name of Powell. You know him? Served on, huh?
No, I know, Bobby.
I reckon he served on the board last year. Does that sound right? But he had Junior Bennett served on the same board?
Well, that could have been.
Well, he says Powell's ready to go. So I asked him to go ahead and call Mr. Powell and sort of tell him. I just told him there's a movement underway, and basically we felt like we'd get the changes made. And I told him go ahead and call Mr. Powell and check his temperature, and then we'd be back in touch with him in a day or two. So he seemed to think, he said that if the fire was stirred in Georgia, said that Georgia just about goes solid, is what he told me.
Well, I think so. They've had a lot of unrest back down there before.
Well, this is sort of what it looked to me like. got a, we've got a meeting coming up Wednesday, Thursday, here at Paris. And it'll cover a pretty good portion of West Tennessee, and it's a pretty quiet meeting. And I don't know what'll come of it.
Well, your directors will be gone, and the fire will be on in Corning by that time.
Well, that'd probably be just as well.
Yeah, it would.
Probably be just as well.
Light a fire there. If you get one of them rebels in that area to light the fire for you, see? Have you got a rebel down there that'll light it?
I think so. I feel like I have, anyway.
And get it going, you know, that the people will follow.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is sort of, it's sort of what I feel like we might be able to do.
You ever talk to Grover Wynn, though, boy?
No, I haven't been able to get a hold of Grover nor Bill Beach either. I feel like that they'll, they're ready anyway, you know, but I haven't been able to get a hold of them. I tried this afternoon to get a hold of Bill and Grover both and couldn't, but maybe I can get a hold of them early in the morning.
What about up in Indiana country?
Well, I don't know. There's one or two people up there we might depend on, because I felt like maybe somebody else, you know, some of y'all might go and talk to Utley. Might go. I don't know, but I've understood that that he probably would. If you know, in other words, he's sitting on the fence probably.
Mm-hmm.
And so I don't know whether he would or not. Well, is there any more news?
Oh, not other than the board meeting's coming up. We're still all accusations are flying every direction. They got me running around the country with all the women.
Just regular Casanova, huh?
Yeah, and they got Melvin running around the country with all the women.
Is that right?
Yeah, he's supposed to got some woman pregnant up in Corning, Iowa now.
Is that right? Well, that old bald-headed devil, I didn't think he had it in.
That's the damnedest thing I ever saw, Bobby. I never saw people get assassinate people so damn much. They just sit around and dream up that damn crap, see?
Mm-hmm. Well, is the money, is it, has any of them, California, any of them pulled their custodial accounts?
Have they pulled it?
Yeah.
I think one area out there is quit going through it, from what I hear, but I don't know if that's true or not. But hell, as far as any movement concerned through the account, I think it's almost come to a halt anyway.
Well, that sort of promotes the purpose then, doesn't it?
Well, if it does, yeah. I mean, if they do, yeah.
Yeah.
But at this point, I don't know of any that have deliberately pulled out. But I think it's just the birds, you know.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to go up there to that damn board meeting. They're going to throw a big damn deal in there fixing to just take care of themselves, what's fixing to. Because that's going to put the icing on the cake. First thing, and what they're going to attempt to do, of course, is try to get us off the board, and they'll probably get that job done because we'll probably let them. And when they walk, we walk out that door, we'll might as well lock that one up there.
Should be all over with then, won't it?
Out there and played on his ego, and he sat out there on that farm and, you know, retired, nobody paying any mind to him, and he just used the organization too long, and went on. went back out there and got him. He couldn't wait. He couldn't get there fast. First thing he did was send him down there to represent the organization before those platform committees, both the Democratic and Republican parties, Democratic Party anyway, and man, he just strutted his stuff. He was real proud, which was fine. That was not the problem. But to come back and be a hatchet man for the reason that he himself quit is a different thing. And he took his servant's pay and all that, which I thought he was entitled to. I'm not judging him that. But just to come back like this is a different deal, too.
Well, Don, how much more time or is it going to be? Will it be before this this blamed custodial account comes up red?
Well, there's going to be an audit of the custodial account, Bobby, period.
Y'all are going to force one.
It's going to come one way or the other. If they vote the son of a bitch down, it's coming through some other manner. Because hell fire, any member out here can file an injunction with organization demanding accounting, and he can get it. And it's just, they're just playing with time, and the damn board sitting there fat, dumb, and happy letting the thing go on. If we let it go on anymore without us stopping it and taking a stand on it, well, hell, every one of them are liable up to their full net worth, maybe even more if the damn thing comes up short, and I'm not going to be in that position. And I intend to see to it that, by God, I'm not. If the rest of them want to do it, fine. That's stupid. Let people sit up there like Staley and Lashman, those boys, and ramrod that damn thing and run it without them people knowing one thing about it, that $1 million shortage or some such thing could kill them. Destroy every one of them.
An organization, too.
Why, hell yeah. Let's destroy it anyway from the very damn misuse of the thing. I'm telling you, there's not enough confidence left out here in this people in this thing, Bobby, to get the water hot. Pissed the ass along with a million bushel here and a million bushel yonder, and hell, we cutting a big hole, you know. Hell far. How'd you ever get their mind to open up wide enough to get out of Corning, Iowa? You can't even get them out of the downtown up there. How are we going to control the nation?
Well, whenever we... That's right. Whenever we shut the thing, if we ever get the grain shut off going into those counts, and that account comes up short, then that'll be the peak of the thing in part of the convention, won't it?
Well, it'll be a, or that'll be an automatic audit, but I don't think that's been even attempted at this point yet. I think it's just a matter of the, hell, we just not getting, there's no participation, and the damn thing is all over the country about the custodial account is creating that much more lack of confidence in the thing. But this happened back before the movement ever started. That's what brought on the movement, in fact. And, hell, there's just no other way, Bobby.
Well, now, I didn't go into too many specifics with Marin down there a while ago when I was talking to him. I don't know what I did in some degree. I didn't in other degrees. I didn't know really what angle except to see if they could get something started down there. And I didn't mention anything about the, except for the fact that the statement he made was that, well, he had started before and there was enough people to ask him, you know. And I told him that I felt like that wouldn't happen this time.
No, they're not going to get it done this trip. They're losing their staff, Bobby. Hell, their staff's gone for nothing. They keep on acting like it's still going, you know. I had a man call me right tonight. And he said he wanted to know my opinion. I said, hell, I'm not going to tell you what to do. But he had never been paid since he went to work. Mm-hmm. And he had done, not doing one bit of good. He just give out. He said, hell, I'm just throwing my time away and everything else. He said, I'm not gaining one single thing. What was going on, he'd heard about this thing. I said, well, as far as I know what's going on, well, you know, it's just people are tired and fed up with it. Organization's dying, dead. You know, we just can't afford to let it go any further. We've got to stop it now and salvage the damn thing. If it's salvageable, that's all there is to it. Of course, it's the opposite, you know, that's the opposite of what Staley talks. That's the only thing Staley can hang on to. He's got to prove somebody is trying to destroy the organization because everybody rallies around that banner, see? Or somebody is trying to cut off the money or build a kingdom. Everybody rallies around that damn thing, and he wore it plumb out. But I don't think that's going to work this time because they're going to put the facts where they belong. And they ain't no hold barred.
Well, you know, this is one thing that concerns me there as far as during the interim period here, losing the staff. Because the more that they're running around the country putting out brush fires, the more money is being spent, the less it's going to be to pay in the staff, isn't it?
That's right. That's exactly what's going to happen if he keeps pursuing it like he's doing. Hell, daily getting that airplane yourself could put the brush fires out if you do it. People don't know this, see. He claimed that's what he's done, but what he did was agitate the situation to where he could come home and say, see what I told you?
Mm-hmm.
People are breaking off, and don't worry about it. They're going to set up their kingdom and all this kind of stuff. And rally the troops. Makes him look good. The way he's always survived. But he's going to get his opportunity this time right in front of the group. He's going to be able to know, they're going to be able to know one way or the other what Mr. Stated it is. Because we ain't going out of this with a whimper.
Well, I wouldn't think you'd be doing justice or your own convictions if you did, Don.
Well, I know. But, you know, there's an easy trap when they're in the state of mind they're in. And that's what they're going to do, work themselves into a trap. We're going to capitalize on it if they're stupid enough to go and do it. And they're already doing that.
Hey, you think you're overconfident, Don?
Well, I think they just get so damn silly, see? They can't think straight.
Mm-hmm.
And they get, Bobby, you know, you preach this crap so long, you begin to believe it.
Mm-hmm.
And you think that somebody's after your kingdom, and of course, Daly has nightmares over that every night, you know. That somebody's going to replace him. Now, if everybody understood that and knew what his real motives were, hell, the fight had been over a long time ago. But it's just now beginning to come to light. Now, when it starts coming to light, he starts reacting to it exactly as his motive tells him to, and then the people see it that much more. But this is why he did that. We anticipated, you remember, just exactly what he was doing, and that's what he's done up to point. And
he followed the game plan pretty well, hasn't he?
Yeah, he just come right down the road. We figured he'd go to the country and try to beat the people behind. As soon as he met the opposition strong enough, he'd call an immediate board meeting and try to kick us off the board. And they term this as an emergency board meeting. And hell, it's a it should be a regular schedule board meeting.
Is that right?
Unless we're due one latter part of this month, see.
And it was termed an emergency board meeting.
Special board meeting.
Special board meeting.
Yeah. There's no question. For the purpose of kicking out every man up there. And they claim they got a tape up there on this thing. Did you see anybody taping that meeting?
Not to my knowledge. There wasn't any tape recorders in the meeting.
Yeah, they claim they got a tape on it and all that bullshit, which is nothing more than try to drive a wedge between people.
There wasn't no tape recorder in the meeting down there that day.
Well,
the only thing it could have done, it would have had to been bugged and arranged with the motel there, and the only person that could have done that would have been Bob Spears, and I don't think he would have done it.
But nobody knows where it was. Anyway, they're claiming they got a tape of it, hold down a bit. And they got a story out on you, and I'll tell you about it when you get to Corny.
What is it?
Well, you're the squealer of the bunch.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, that's about par for course, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, that's about par for course.
Now, you're supposed to have taped it all in the next morning after the meeting.
Is that right?
Corning, Iowa, and they're supposed to have it all on tape.
Mm-hmm. Now, that's about par for course. You know, I had a fella there that night, down there, the first night, that told me that I was a dead SOB if I wasn't straight, you know, at Wichita. So I'd say it's about par for course, you know.
Did somebody tell you that?
Yeah.
Oh, hell, did you really?
Yeah. Yes, I sure did.
Well, a lot of boys didn't know you there.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, I was the one that called you, and they settled up and talked to me about it, and I said, hell, Bar, he wouldn't be here if he wasn't what he was, and that's it. And that was the end of it. Nobody questioned anymore.
How's the thing look up in Kansas?
Good.
Looks good.
They had that 19th. Did I talk to you since that 19th district meeting and Devon was up there?
You just said that he was up there.
Well, they was up there and they had it round and round again. And they got everybody treed and they didn't come down when the meeting was over.
Is that right? Got Devon treed too, huh?
And Devon finally wound up telling people that, you know, if that's you, whatever your feelings are, we'll fight for what you believe in.
Fight your conviction.
Daly will damn sure go for that one.
I'd say he'd go for that in a big way. Yes, I'd say he'd go for that now.
That's where a part of the stuff's supposed to come out on. for problems. I've heard that damn thing. I tell you what, I've heard that accusation ever since I've been on that board to somebody all the time.
Somebody's always got a zipper problem.
Yeah, they come out with that damn story every time, and they always level it at those that they fear the most, or somebody they think caused them some problems somewhere they need to get rid of, and you damn near tell every one of them that they're afraid of, because there's always story running around on them. And he's got another going, they got one going on Avon, they may wish to hell they could never start it.
Is that right?
So damn sure take them to the courtroom, don't think he won't. If AFPI doesn't polish us off, by God, he may. Nah, hell, he's really mad about it.
Well, I'm not surprised at him being mad about it. And that's the reaction I'd expect from him on the thing.
That's crazy.
I think anybody else that knew Avon would have expected the same thing from him.
Well, what's new? Anything else down there going on?
No, I think I done created as much havoc as I can for one for one time. So I don't know of anything else hardly, except I did talk to Marion, and I just sort of think we might ride along here for a day or two and let him think it over and make some contacts, and then go back in there and contact him again. I was supposed to go down there this week. I'm not going to be going, so we'll just have to let her ride along and see how she's going. And I think they'll come around. Not too much problem down there.
Well, are they going to call you to Corning in for me?
I'm going to be up there Friday. I expect the board meeting to be over with Friday.
Well, don't be surprised if it's not.
Because, see, we have our assistant director's meeting immediately following the board meeting. Because Shelf and a bunch of them on the sale horse and Shelf. I don't know. There's one or two more of them that are on the board, see.
Where will Sell Horse wind up this thing?
I don't know, Don. I don't know. I never have talked to the guy or anything. Just what little I've heard, and I ain't heard much. Well, I heard the same thing you heard at Wichita the other day.
Well, I know that when Ken Thompson and the boys took him on a year ago, Sell Horse for sure in favor of it. Now, where you'll stand this time, I don't know.
Well, I wouldn't have any idea. I don't know. I've been in one staff meeting with him, or two staff meetings with him, and that's all I know about the man, is what I've seen out there. I've never been in a meeting with him or anything, you know. I know he's raising Cain about the meat problem, and they put him in the meat problem over Nebraska. That's all I know about it. Excuse me, really.
What's the meat department doing now? I understand the production's way off.
Well, I really don't know how it is nationwide. I expect that it could be. In our area, we reached a peak back there, and we fell off of the peak, and we haven't been able to build back any momentum on the thing.
Why did it fall off, buddy?
Well, I don't know. We may have promised them too much. Imagine that could be it.
Well, that could be it. I don't know. I didn't follow the meat that much, except the one thing I do know, it'll be the constant damn bicycle up and down like that until we find it locked together. But hell, until they wake up to the fact they got to have mechanical systems that they don't even comprehend up there, yet we're fiasco when that happens. If they start to work immediately on that, get that corrected, hell, within 3 months' time, they can lock the damn thing down.
That's right. Well, you know, it's one thing on his income.
This is why it's just gradually deteriorating. And hell, they're trying to sit up there and beat the damn drum, call it something else, but that's a fact. And as this thing continues to move, and hell, it's going to move, because the people are ready. I'm telling you, they're coming to arms. You can hold a meeting anywhere, and hell, you don't have to hold a meeting. The people hold the meeting.
Well, what's the situation on the news? Have they just quit sending them in?
No, the people just quit paying their dues.
Just generally?
Yeah, you know, the dues is paying its way down, and it just boils back to one thing, nothing but a failure in the overall approach to the commodity program. People join this organization, they joined it for one reason, that one of these days we're going to put her together as soon as we organize. Hell, we've been organized for 2 years. And we're going to lock it together, and we're going to set a price on it. And hell, we ain't locking it together. We're not even trying. We're still running around volunteer programs. It's a damn disaster every time you come. one because of the inherent nature of a farmer. And it's inevitable every time you perceive one because you present one, because as soon as you do have the effect of success in moving the market, the other members that don't have to participate sit out there and take the advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as soon as you say no, buddy, you're going to participate from here on in or you're out of the damned organization. They'll come on in. They're ready. But hell, I've had them tell me that. Then what in the hell should I do that for? When you guys are ready to tie it together, we'll do it. Hell, everybody else sitting down here getting the other nickel, I am too.
Yep, that's right. That's what they'll tell you out there.
I'll tell you what, you come with a massive move and well-programmed, well-planned movement to tie this damn thing together, and I mean no loose ends, but the concentration on perfection of implementation. I'm talking about the workings day by day. And let them see a success one time and let them come out with more money than anybody else, and you better open the damn gates because they ain't enough membership agreements in Corning, Iowa, now.
I think they had to run that Heidelberg day and night to stay up.
Yeah. Now they use them brass wiping papers up there because they got more of them than what to do with.
I ain't never heard it put that way exactly.
Well, that's about all you can say for it, isn't it?
Well, yeah, you're right.
People getting out of the damned organization every day and quit paying their dues. Hell, that's getting out, period. They can talk about 10 days before, 10 after, and all this bullshit they want to, but when people are not participating and don't intend to, they're out. As far as we're concerned, getting it along here with probably 3% of the total production in the organization, hell. And you can sit up there and talk to them, Bobby, you blew in the face, and hell, they can't even comprehend what you're saying. They don't understand what's going on out here. They don't understand what the hell they got to do to win. Talk about, you talk, I heard a boy say the other day on a truthful statement. He said, by God, Corny don't understand collective bargaining. That's the problem. And that's just exactly right. They understand the principle. They don't understand the detailed movement of accomplishing that goal.
Mechanics involved.
Yeah, and hell, the stair-step methods and all this kind of stuff, they see that reaction. But we is, shit, it's so unreal, it's not even funny. But the thing is so sad, Bobby, about the whole deal, is so many men so dedicated across this country. In years past and up to the present, are still out there beating their heads against the wall, working like a dog, believing all that stuff, when it's true that it could work, but it's impossible for it to work with circumstances like it is in the organization. That's what's really sad about it. If there's anything curled my blood, that's it. The constant damn hatchet work, the constant damn assassination, anything to maintain a one-man political position, what it boils down to, and hell, it don't make a difference who it costs. And we've lost some pretty damn precious people, I'll guarantee you that. As far as the organization is concerned, whether we like them or whether we don't like them, that's immaterial.
Mm-hmm.
But the value to the organization is irreplaceable. How many people do you suppose still in this organization working that was here 3 years ago?
I don't know, Don. I imagine the percentage is pretty small.
Damn right. And anytime you've got that kind of rollover percentage and that kind of lack of people with training and know-how and experience, there ain't no way you can win. Now, those people, they don't understand that. Because the board don't understand it, Daly can use them. And he'll do it. And they believe him. As long as they continue to do that, it's a dead pigeon. Oh, you get out here and beat a brush fire here and beat one yonder and pick up a new leader, don't know anything about what's going on, you know. And that's what he's planning on doing back in the Midwest. Got to go back and reorganize things. All them old leaders in there, all them old people that's members back there 10 years ago, they all died off, Gordon Staley. Now got to go back and get some money. What happened is he hit the West Coast and organized everything that listened to him swing here and there. Now he's got to go back to them old areas he started 15 years ago that told him to chuck it. He's got to go back and pick out new people there to get them going again. It's just, you know, that can go on for a hell of a long time.
Yeah,
he
should be back to the West Coast.
Keep them alive. But not me.
How's Druckmeyer sitting?
Well, I think Druckmeyer's committed down the road. With the people.
With the people.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Because I don't know what'll happen if Warren Lee gets a hold of it. But he don't have much choice. He's got to go with these people. And these people are damn sure going. Well, of course, they've just got one choice, really. And that choice isn't very wide. They either come to grips with this blow-up going on nationwide, or she's damn sure over, one or the other. And it's over if they don't. So, Daly's gonna, he's gonna come head nose to nose, toes to toes with it.
Did you ever get your welfare straightened out?
No. No, I'm still working on that, D-Lo. I can never persuade the federal government to do it, but I could probably persuade the organization bigger than I could them to pay a unemployment fee. Can't you see that?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Hell, I tell you what, I wonder how many more fixers get fired.
I don't know. I just expected. Do you know whether Ron Mattis is still with us or not?
No, I don't.
I just figure he'll probably get it, and I'll get it. I don't know. There's two or three more there the other day that were still working. I figure they'll all get it. Moscow ain't got it yet.
No, he hasn't got it yet, but he expects it.
He expects it.
If he don't get it, he'll probably resign anyway. He wants them fine.
Well, he'll probably get his wish on it, won't he?
Yeah, they're just that crazy. They couldn't have done anything any worse than fire Ken Spencer. That just drove the damn wedge deep. There ain't no way they'll ever recover it. Not with Daly in there.
Think North Dakota's written off, huh?
He's gone.
And they quit sending their money in?
I don't know, Bobby, whether they have or not. I'd imagine they have, because those people up there, man, they're in arms. California is unhappy as hell. Those people out there, of course, when Staley made his tour here a while back, they locked horns with him then on a massive scale. Then to Kansas, they down there run him out of state. The boys down here told him, by God, don't come to Texas.
Who was it?
One of our people out here.
Did I know him?
Yeah, you know him. He told him, by God, don't come to Texas. Whatever you do.
One of the district president was.
No, it wasn't him.
Is that right?
And I tell you what, he damn sure better take that advice, too. They damn sure mean it.
Yeah, I figure the old district president down there might issue that kind of ultimatum.
Yeah, well, district president, he's fighting me now.
He is?
Yeah, he wants me off the board. Hell, I told him fine. Make me a damn good difference. I'm not running the board anyway. Just want him to be damn sure and there and ready when the time came.
Want him to be ready to fight when the time came.
Show him the damn wolves and let them chew on him for a couple of years. Nah, Don's all right, hell. He just got to be off to every damn thing he come up with. When he, everybody settles their farrow, he's right with it.
He'll be right down the line, won't he?
Yeah.
Well, listen, I got to go. I just wanted to talk to you about Marin and this little meeting we're going to have over here. I don't know what'll come of it. I won't be at it, but my chief advisor will, so.
Well,
boss running for the board will be at it.
They need to stir it up and move it, Bobby.
Well, I think they're going to. The only thing we were hesitant about was on this these collection points as to whether everybody else had put sending their checkoff in or what the status was on the thing. In other words, whether they put sending in these points or not put or keep sending in. You know, the packer pays a check back to the local custodial account.
Well, I say, Packer does pay the local custodial account?
Yeah. And then the local custodian at each collection point sends a check off in to the home office.
Uh-huh.
Well, of course, we're collecting dues, too, sending those in.
Right. Well, I can tell you that it'll all depend on what happens at this board meeting. But if that board meeting doesn't go like it should go, then I expect there'll be a mass down movement to shut her down.
Financially.
Hell, every other way you can do it. We're going to get him one way or the other. Because if there's no hope for it unless you do.
This is the thing. Of course, our custodial account isn't like grain. You know, we don't have a national custodial account. We don't have one anymore. I got one collection point that's on the national custodial account. And all the rest of them are on locals. And,
you see, this is the same damn thing they're fighting in grain.
Mm-hmm.
All we're asking is a custodial account within the marquee area.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, I know why they're fighting so damn bad, because they're short on that son of a gun up there.
Mm-hmm.
And if it comes out of corning, that charge is going to show up.
Mm-hmm.
But, hell, they don't have any choice now.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't want to, in other words, here's my thinking on it. If we make a maverick move over here, and this, of course, this meeting coming up, if that purpose to decide, you know, what to do. And we didn't want to make a maverick move. If everybody else was still sent in, we quit. Well, then, of course, you know, it'd be, of course, I expect the other areas, you know, the hog areas that haven't got anything started yet, I expect them to keep sending in, but I'm talking about the grain area.
Well, of course, over here, as far as any movement in grain money going to Corning, the only money that's going to Corning now is what the companies are sending direct to Corning. And Corning's trying to keep that going, so that's the way it's been programmed.
Mm-hmm.
But the movement of grain in the areas has come to a halt.
Mm-hmm.
Nebraska's about the only one that's paid any checkoffs amount to anything the last 30 days. I mean,
mm-hmm.
It went to nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to stay that way from here on.
How long can he operate like that?
Well, it's over right now.
It's over right now.
Operating on nothing more than employee salaries, Bobby. They're just a financing organization right down the line.
Well, that'll have the effect of shutting her down, won't it?
Well, sure, it's just building up.
Well, that'll have the effect of shutting her down. Well, listen, I don't know. Marion didn't ask me anything about who would be a possible replacement, so I guess that'll come up after this board meeting if there's, you know, we'll see which way she goes.
You mean of Orrin Lee?
Yeah.
Well, I expect there'll be two or three candidates running anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I think.
Well, I told him there's a wide range to choose from.
And there's some good men. And I'm sure some good men capable.
Well, listen, I gotta go. I'll let you go. I'd blame this thing here to break me. It's these kind of phone calls.
Set them afire and get them rolling.
Okay.
Okay, Bobby.
Talk to you later.
All right, bye-bye.